Hi, I'm Thomas Schwarz from Eberle. In this video, I will show you everything you need to know about power quality reports. I will explain how to make design adjustments and which setting and configuration is best for your individual report. To create a PQ report, I open a measurement file with the WinPQ Mobil software. Then I click on the norm evaluation symbol with the red-blue columns. WinPQ Mobil now shows me a standard evaluation of the measurement data. For the print view, I click on the printer symbol. On the first page, I see basic information about the measurement and the PQ box itself. Below this, an overview appears in which I can see at a glance whether limit values have been violated in the respective categories. Further details on the measurement data and limit values follow on page 2. Then there are the harmonics in graphical and tabular form, and finally data on PQ events, which are useful for statistical evaluation. In the first step, I will show you how you can customize the header in the upper area as well as the logo. Under Setup, General Settings, I can find everything I need for the labels and titles within my header. I can change all the texts in the lower area and they are immediately displayed in the preview above. The comments 1, 2, 3 and 4, which I can already set in the measurement data management, are also displayed. Of course, I can change them here. If I want to change the logo on my report, I must observe the specified size of 1200 by 400 pixels and resolution of 300 dpi. I have already prepared an appropriate logo and select it in the dialog box. With the logo of a different size, the image is stretched to the specified dimensions and looks different than expected. The title at the top center refers to the standard according to which the measurement data is evaluated. I can change this in the report settings. At Setup Report Settings, the report name is displayed. I can edit the title of my standard evaluation here. As soon as I change a parameter in this window, such as the name, I have to save the current setting once as a file. I click on Yes and save everything for this demonstration under the name temp. WinPQ Mobil offers a wide range of standards from all over the world for evaluating power quality. From EN50160, which is widely used in Europe, to the globally valid IEC 61000-2-4 for industrial networks and the IEEE 519. If I get confused with my settings, I can load the default settings with just one click. In the General tab, I can find further setting options, which I will now explain. For the voltage harmonics, I can choose between an evaluation up to the 25th harmonic, 40th or 50th harmonic. If I reduce the selection to 25, the report on page 3 only shows 25 columns per phase in the bar chart, and in the table on page 4 only the rows to the 25th harmonic. If I activate the interharmonics, the report grows by 2 additional pages and shows the corresponding graphs and tables for these values. Of course, I can also deactivate the evaluation completely. The measurement of supraharmonics from 2 kHz to 9 kHz is only possible from the PQBox 150 expert onwards. Consequently, only then will the evaluation be displayed in the report. An additional category, supraharmonics, appears in the overview and the data is displayed graphically and in tabular form from page 4. The supraharmonics from 9 to 150 kHz from a PQBox 300 can also be found in the report following the same pattern. The PQ events can be evaluated according to various criteria. Here too, WinPQ Mobil offers the right option for every application. The event matrix on the last page of the report changes depending on the selection. Another point is the evaluation of long-term data. Basically, a distinction is made here as to whether percent quantiles of the measurement data are used or all data including the maximum values.
What is a percent quantile?
Here is an example. I have 160 measurement points with the following progression over time. In the first step, I sort the data in ascending order from minimum to maximum. I then change the horizontal axis scaling from 0 to 100%. I now represent the lower 95% of my measurement data with a red column. Its highest value corresponds to the 95% quantile. The remaining upper 5% of the data is represented by a blue column. For the evaluation, WinPQ Mobil now scales the columns in relation to the limit value. This limit value only ever applies to the red columns. This is because certain standards define their limit values for precisely these percent quantiles. For some measured values, such as the voltage changes, there is an upper and lower limit value. For better visualization, the higher absolute value is shown. Graphically, the lower column is folded upwards and only the higher of the two columns is displayed. The main purpose of flagging is to avoid counting power quality events twice. Unpredictable events such as voltage swells, dips, or interruptions automatically flag all recorded measurement data for their entire duration. A measurement variable determined from this data, such as the flicker, may not be a real flicker at all, but actually a voltage dip. Thanks to the flagging concept, I can now decide in WinPQ Mobil whether this measurement data should be taken into account or not when creating the report. With tangent phi, I can display the mean value of the ratio reactive power to active power in the report. The evaluation of ripple control signals can also be deactivated. In the report, the corresponding category disappears in the overview on page 1 and in the details on page 2. If I want to evaluate the voltage tolerance, I activate the corresponding item. WinPQ Mobil now generates a table in the report. There I can see how many measured values are within and outside the tolerance bands for the nominal voltage. In the section Limits Statistics, I can set the exact parameters for the quantiles of each individual category of measured values. The limit values of each individual voltage harmonic can be edited in the Harmonics 2-50 tab. To select the order of a harmonic voltage, I simply click on a column in the diagram or I use the order field at the top right. I can adjust the tolerance level below. For the interharmonics, I can enter a fixed limit value or accept the limit value of the next harmonic. I use a similar principle to set the limit values for the supraharmonics from 2 kHz to 9 kHz and from 9 to 150 kHz.
I can also make settings in the configuration of my PQ box that will affect my report.
In the menu of the PQ box itself or here in WinPQ Mobil at Measurement Device Configuration, I can choose between different device connections. In a classic 4-wire system configuration in the low voltage grid, the PQ box evaluates the voltages between the line conductor and neutral conductor. In a three-wire system, however, which is common in medium voltage grids, it evaluates the line-to-line voltages. Consequently, only the evaluated line-to-line values appear in the report, as here in a measurement in the medium voltage grid. Both for the voltage changes and the flicker, THD or harmonics. This evaluation cannot be changed retrospectively. However, all relevant voltages are always measured and recorded. In the permanent record section, I can therefore also see the voltages between the line and neutral, or line and earth, as both are at the same potential. Here, I can clearly see that the line-to-line voltages are okay, but that there were repeated earth faults. These were, of course, reliably recorded by the PQ box as fault records, regardless of the 3 or 4 wire configuration. Under PQ events, I define the limits for voltage changes. For example, the point at which a swell, dip, or interrupt is detected. The values are given as a percentage of the nominal voltage. These values have a direct impact on the flagging of measurement data and cannot be subsequently edited for a recording that has already been completed. If the limit values are too strict, the PQ box may flag all measured data and I will not see anything in the evaluation as long as flagged values are excluded. If I deactivate flagging, the data is displayed. For a report in accordance with IEEE 519, it is important that two crucial parameters are set correctly in the configuration of the PQ box before the measurement begins. Firstly, the report requires the 3-second data, and secondly, the measuring interval must be set to 600 seconds. When I load the corresponding configuration in WinPQ Mobil, these parameters are already preset. If my measurement data meets these criteria, the corresponding icon for the evaluation according to IEEE 519 is active.